Some people may find my topic today very offensive. You may find it offensive because I want to ensure that you do not forget it. I will give you an alternative in case you don't like my offensive title.
Bi akori ti mo fe lo ba ba olara mu ko le fun olakori miran.
What you are looking at this one is called
ohun ti e o se ayewo re lo wuro yin mo pe ni
the penis dowry.
Owo ori oko.
Why do you like
to ba si wo
foreskin dowry.
O le pe ni owo ori atoto.
If you like
o ba wo
reproductive organ dowry.
O le pe ni owo ori
but I call it penis dowry.
Ṣugbọn owo ori oko emi pe.
In 1 Samuel chapter 18,
iwe kini Samueli orikeji din ni ogun
verse 25.
Ese ikarun din ni ogun.
1 Samuel chapter 18,
iwe kini Samueli orikeji din ni ogun
verse 25.
Ese ikarun din logbon.
If you are there, say yes.
Eniba ti sibe o wi pe be ni.
Here was a beautiful woman, the daughter of a king. The king wanted to marry her to an important fellow. And that king now decided on a form of dowry. Let us see the dowry that was received for this lady. And let us see what happened to the lady later. Let us examine carefully what happened to the marriage where this kind of dowry was used. In 1 Samuel chapter 18, verse 25.
And
Saul said, "Thus shall ye say to David." The king desired not any dowry, but 100 foreskin of the Philistines to be avenged of the king's enemies. But Saul thought to make David fall by the hand of the Philistines.
Because
there is no way you are going to cut off the penis of a soldier without killing him
first.
So Saul thought that, well, if I ask him to bring this kind of dowry, 100 foreskins of the enemy, by the time he kills the first one, second one, third one, so one of them will kill him.
And
when his servants told David these
words,
it pleased
David
well to be the king's son-in-law, and the days were not expired. Wherefore David arose
and
went, he and his men, and slew of the Philistines 200 men instead of the 100 they even asked
for.
They doubled the dowry for this lady. And David brought their foreskins, and they gave them in full tale to the king, that he might be the king's son-in-law. And Saul gave him Michal, his daughter, to wife. That was how this lady got married. That was the dowry that was collected. Listen, beloved. There is something known as the evil harvest. There is something known as generational harvest. There is something in deliverance they call root enemies. Enemies at the root. There is something known as foundational warfare. There There is something known as harrows from the foundation. There is something known as foundational crack. There is something known as foundational voices. There is something known as foundational marching order. Listen and listen to me very carefully, beloved. In this life, the foundation of anything you do is very crucial. There is foundation to every wealth. The foundation of that wealth must be right. If it's not right, you will definitely pay for it and your children's children. I feel sorry for all those looking for wealth in magic, sorcery, kidnapping. They will do nothing with that wealth. The wealth will destroy them and their children. Those who have done so in the past have done nothing with such monies. I feel sorry for those who are trafficking drugs. If that is the foundation of the wealth you claim to have, you are a great pauper. Only that you didn't know. Because what you have done, the foundation you have laid, will certainly backfire. Academics must have a good foundation. If you got into the university, got to anywhere with a fake certificate, the foundation is wrong.
As
long as you are carrying a fake passport, anywhere you go with it, your staying in that place is already faulty. Sometimes all these people waste the time of pastors, prophets, and deliverance ministers. Because they have a bad foundation and they are looking for somebody to treat the plant that has grown out of the bad foundation. Are you running a business? The foundation of that business must be good. If it's terrible, if it's bad, if it's in occultism, sacrifices of that, stealing from there, you are not going anywhere with that. It will backfire. It will not only kill you physically, spiritually, but will start killing your offsprings. The foundation of the marriage of Michal was foreskin of Philistines, death of Philistines. You are having a ministry, a church. The foundation of it must be solid. Listen and listen to me well, no matter what you think you know. Any church you start on the foundation of rebellion, disloyalty, stealing will not last.
Because
the foundation is wrong. You may run for a while. 10 years. Even 20 years. It's like you have unplugged a present iron from the electricity. It will still be hot for a while. But the cold period will come. When the mad winds of anti-ministry power comes against you.
Nigba ti a fe be isinwin ti awon ogun to lodi si ise iranse ba dide si o.
And your foundation is faulty.
Ti ipile re o si gunrege.
You fall flat.
O subu yakata.
This is why we have so many churches but only few are doing very well.
Idi ni ti ijo bi pore pete sugbon die lo nse daada.
Many have started in rebellion.
Opo lo bere pelu ote.
But it doesn't say they cannot preach Christ.
For
the Bible
says,
some preach Christ out of strife.
Some
preach Christ out of contention.
But it
doesn't matter as far as Christ is preached.
They are
just like bus conductors who will not enter into the
work.
Family.
Idile.
The foundation of family is very important.
Ipele idile o se pataki.
The way you found your husband, the way you found your wife.
Bo se ri oko re, bo se ri iyawo re.
If you are in a home now,
bo ba wa ni ile kan bayi,
you just pack your load and moved in.
Se je ko kan keru wo be ni.
No dowry.
Won o sanwo ori.
No engagement.
Won o se dana.
No family.
Won o se mo mi mo.
You just say I love you, I love you, and because of the love that you say you have, love in quote, you moved in.
The
foundation of that marriage is already in trouble. So going to deliverance now to start praying, you're wasting the time of the deliverance
ministers.
The foundation of any relationship you have is important. One man met his wife. He went to a native doctor. As he was coming out, he met the woman going to the native doctor. So they met in the front of the native doctor's house. And they started loving themselves in court from that place. So the man married this woman whom he met at the door of the witch doctor's house. 10 years later, he ran to Christ, claiming that the wife is a witch. And I told him, what do you expect? You picked that up from the witch doctor's house. So you expect that to be an angel?
Said
no. Said man of God, doesn't mean that it's nothing I can do.
And
I said, way out. Deliverance. And God's mercy. I was in England for my PhD in the early 80s. A friend of mine came to my house.
I
said, Daniel, I'm expecting my wife tomorrow. Will you follow me to the airport to welcome my wife? I said, that's fine. I was free. So I followed him. And so we went to Gatwick Airport. And we stayed there.
As a drone.
The place was lifeless to start with. But immediately the Nigerian plane arrived. Those who were sleeping woke up. And then we were waiting for them at the arrival. And people were coming from Nigeria. And I was asking my friend, where is she?
I
said, wait. He put his hand in his pocket and brought out a picture. And he was looking at those who were coming. And the picture. I said, You mean?
Eh?
You have never met her. Said no. Said they posted that to me. I said okay. So we waited. And we were even going to give up. When we saw this lady lighting complexion coming. He looked at the picture. Looked at her face. Looked at the picture. Looked at her face. Shouted her name.
He
said, yes. They embraced each other. That was how they met. At the airport. Arrival hall. With a picture. 6 months later, I went to my friend's house because somebody called me and said, it's emergency, I should come. My friend found his way to the roof. I said, what are you doing there?
He
said, he wants to commit suicide. He wants to jump down. He said, why? Said my wife. Said which wife?
Yawo.
Said the one we went to collect at the airport. Said yes. Anything wrong with her? Said no. Said she has followed one German man. She ran away. I said, so because of that, we want to die. She's gone. What do you expect? You collected her at the airport. Now she flew away again. You know,
Chairman.
The Yorubas have a proverb.
I want Yoruba ma pa owe kan.
And the wife you marry in the dancing hall.
Obirin ta ba fe nile ijo
will disappear through the same entertainment. There is a proverb in our land too. They say it is what the bird has eaten that the bird will fly with. It is when the bird has not eaten something bad. If the bird has eaten above what the bird should eat, it won't fly. If the
bird has eaten what the bird should eat,
so you have a building, you are living in a house. It has a foundation. Sometimes people plant things in the foundation of a house. And people who live there never prosper. We went to a place. It was in England. And we were looking at a house. The woman next door neighbor thought we wanted to buy the house. She came out. I said, come. So we went.
I said,
I hope you are not trying to buy this house.
He
said, no. I just said, admiring it.
Said,
if you are planning to buy it, don't buy it.
Because
the two former occupants died of heart attack. She had just told us the secret of the place. I'm praying for somebody here this morning. If you are living in a place where the foundation is attacking your destiny, may the Lord relocate you to a better place in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Sex
ibalopo
has a foundation.
Oni ipile.
Your sexual foundation is important to your life.
Ipile ibasepo re o se pataki ninu oro aye re.
The man who disparages a lady has a serious spiritual implication to that lady.
Okunrin to ba ja ibale obirin oni ipa to lewu to le ko ninu igbe aye mi re.
You form a covenant with that man.
Nitori pe o ti da majemu pelu okunrin.
He has broken into you and wetted his organ with your blood.
O wo inu re o si fi
so a blood covenant is formed. This is why we preach that there must not be sex before marriage. It pollutes every other thing. Unless you atone for it and pray about it. Employment as foundation.
Iṣẹ́ ṣíṣe ó ní ìpìlẹ̀.
Certificate as foundation.
Ìwé ẹ̀rí ó ní ìpìlẹ̀.
Even your Christianity,
koda igbe aye Christiani re
gan, as a Christian,
gege bi Christiani,
it has a foundation.
Oni ipile.
If you get born again where there is no sound Bible doctrine,
nigba to ba di atunbi nibi ti won o ti ko eko bibeli to ye koro,
all they do is to dance.
Gbo ti won kan mo nse ni lati tadireke.
No sound Bible teaching,
ko si iko ni ni eko bibeli to ranle.
No sound Bible culture,
ko si asa bibeli to jinle.
No doctrinal standards,
ko si ipele ati ilana.
No fear of God. No baptism of the Holy Spirit. No culture of prayer. That is how you, the foundation from which you got born again. It will breed Christians that are easily defeated by the enemy and Christians who do not fear God.
Yo gbe awon Christians ti o beru Olorun soke yo si je ki ki ota ma tete bori won.
It is important that you understand what I'm saying now. Every country too has a foundation. That's why in territorial deliverance we do spiritual mapping. This is a very, very serious matter. All the abortions that are done has blood crying against those who do
it.
And some have been suffering from that. If God has sent a prophet to earth to come and deliver people, and you have aborted the prophet in your womb, the blood of all those the prophet is coming to save comes upon you. And if you don't atone for it or call upon God to help you, it will fight you. Deliverance will not help.
Bi o ba se atunse lori re ko kepe Olorun ko wa ran lowo yo ma ba oja itusile o si nile ran lowo.
Foundation. What is the foundation of the marriage between David and Michal? What gave Michal so much problem and headache? Look at
2
Samuel.
2 Samuel.
Chapter 6,
Orikefa.
Second Samuel, chapter 6,
Iwekeji Samueli Orikefa,
verse 23.
Ese Iketa Leni Ogun.
Look at the result of the Phinehas dowry.
Ewo ipari owo ori oko.
200 reproductive organs of men were cut off to marry her.
Won ke nkan mokunrin igba eniyan kuro lati le sebe yawo pelu re.
Result, 2 Samuel 6:23.
Iwekeji Samuel ori kefa ese iketa le ni ogun.
Therefore Michal,
Mikali,
the daughter of Saul,
omobirin Saulu,
had no child,
ko si bi omo,
unto the day of her death,
titi o fi di ojo iku re.
The foundation,
ipele.
Unlike other women in the Bible,
yato si ti awon obirin obiran ninu bibeli,
who were claimed to be barren,
ti won pe lagan,
but who eventually had uncommon children,
sugbon to ti won papa bi omo to yato.
Michal died like that.
Michal ku ba yen na ni.
Her father used her as a trap to kill David,
baba re lo gege bi kekun lati le pa David,
which was deception.
Toje itoje.
Her father collected a strange dowry,
baba re gba owo ori ajeji,
which has now brought strange problems.
So wa mo isoro ajeji wa.
They killed 200 men.
Won pa okunrin gba.
Blood was in the foundation of that marriage.
Eje wa ninu ipile igbeyawo yen.
Dowry was 100 foreskin of the Philistines.
Owo ori re ni 100 kan atoto awon Philistine.
Cutting off people's reproductive organs.
Kike nkan mo okunrin awon eniyan kuro.
And so the repercussion is that our own reproduction too was cut off.
Atunboton re ni pe ibimo ti re na ake kuro.
Foundation.
Ipile.
I want to pray one prayer now.
O fe gba adura kan bayi.
As many as want to key into it. Don't let anybody's voice be louder than yours. Father, I'm praying for as many people as are here. That any satanic voice from their foundation will be silenced forever in the name of Jesus. Second prayer. Anyone here suffering because of the sins of their parents, receive your deliverance in the name of Jesus. Let your amen roar like thunder. Sit down for a little bit more. So, foundation determines durability. Determines how long something can last. It determines stability. It determines progress. It determines how good you can stand during the mad winds of life. It determines how positive an impact you can make. It determines your generational blessings. But most importantly, it determines your harvest. It determines your harvest. It determines your harvest. God gives allocation. Allocation. Anything extra that you get outside that divine allocation will bring you trouble and tough consequences. The Bible says a man shall receive nothing except he be given from above. Listen to me very well. God has given you an allocation of the amount of sugar you can eat till you die. Once you exceed that allocation, problem starts. God has given allocation of the amount of fat you can eat. Once you eat over it, trouble will come. Even ordinary human body, that is, God has allocated the amount of water you can put inside. If you exceed the water allocation, or even this vitamin, you exceed the amount of vitamin that body needs, your body reacts madly. God has given you the allocation of the number of sex you should have till you die. Once you have exceeded that allocation, any extra one you do, you're just putting yourself into trouble. I feel sorry for some young ladies now. By 18, they have exceeded all their allocation. They've used everything up. No credit again. Now, anyone they now do after that
one,
it's just extra allocation and extra trouble. This is a problem. Some men, you've exceeded your allocation when you were in secondary school. And so you've exceeded it. After exceeding it, now you now got married. Now there is a problem. That doctors cannot solve, deliverance cannot solve. There is a limit to the talking you can do. Once you have exceeded the allocation of your talking, the extra you say will only give you problems. These are principles people don't understand. It has landed people in hospital, on deliverance ground, going to different prophets all over the place. You can run helter skelter to any prophet. If your problem is an evil harvest, no prophet can help you unless you go back to God.
The
Bible says, God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man sweats, he shall reap also. It's basic. See, you can't, nobody, let nobody deceive you. Somebody can preach another message to you.
See,
God is not mocked. So whatsoever you do,
this is,
that's Galatians chapter 6.
See,
whatsoever a man does, you will reap it. There will always be a harvest. Just like you saw the harvest that Michal received. The grinding machine of God grinds very slowly, but the grind exceedingly small. Whether we like it or not, retribution will have a day. Although the flight of that retribution may be slow, you will eventually do to yourself what you have done to others. Nothing in this world is determined by empty talk. Anyone swallowing poison must die. Unless you stop the poison from working. As your action, so is your recompense. And ashes fly back to the faces of those who throw them. Bad actions may not at once produce its fruit. But it will cut off the root of him who committed it. The Bible says because the judgment against evil act is not speedily done. So the heart of man is strong to do evil. When we say, I don't do what you are doing. But that person has done it, is prospering. That person has done it, is prospering. The Bible says, because the judgment against evil act is not speedily done. Because God is giving them room to repent. So the heart of man is strong to do evil. A teacher. Biology teacher got one of the students in class pregnant. The guy was 16. He got the guy pregnant.
He
denied the pregnancy. Threw the guy's life into disarray. Whereas he too was married. Four children. He had forgotten the life that he had wasted. But he married a strange woman.
He's
part of the repercussion. One day his wife found that he was going out with other women. At that time, the man was 57 years old. With four children who are quite young. This wife did something that I've not seen anybody do before.
She got
so angry because the man was unfaithful. She took her children to the river. Threw them in one by one. Killed all of them. Finish. So let him start from the scratch. The man cried. But he did not remember that many, many years back when he was teaching biology in school, he had messed up one life. There are people like that who have messed up lives. They now run to deliverance ground. They run to prophets. But they will not tell the prophets what they've done wrong. And sometimes they make the prophet to start sweating and praying. And unless you are a good prophet, you may not find out until that the person you are fighting is God, not the devil. The net of heaven is cast wide. And it has large holes. But yet, nothing can slip through it. There is no place on earth to escape to. To run away from the consequences of evil deeds. As you plan evil for another person, heaven is planning evil for you too. Every minute, every hour, you are sowing something in words, in thoughts, in deeds. And there is a reaping coming. A reaping is coming your way for what you have sown. The evil that a man does will eventually go back to him. As long as we have the sun and the moon and the stars, whether you are a sinner or a saint, you will reap what you have sown. Many are suffering now because of what they have sown in the past, which has caught them unawares. Years do not dilute what I'm saying now. Years do not dilute the Lord, they strengthen it. Whether you believe this law or not is irrelevant. There is an evil harvest waiting for every evil deed we are doing, whether great or small. I'd like you to watch all those who are responsible for the woes and troubles of Nigeria and see what will happen to them. If you cheat, somebody too will cheat you. Somebody will backbite against you. If you cause confusion in people's lives, you will cause confusion in your own life too. If you stab people at the back, they will stab you at the back. You steal money, they'll steal your money. So you are digging a pit for your fellow man. You might as well dig too. Because it's a matter of time before you fall into it yourself. Oh, so you are stealing people's wife, you are stealing people's husband. Oh, you will pay heavily for it. Because you say God is not mocked. Was swept by a man sweat that is shari. Children who are here, hear me and hear me very well. The way you treat your parents is how your own children will treat you. The way you disrespect your elders, you are disrespecting your elders now. Don't worry, your own result is approaching. Someone will duplicate the same actions against you. And listen very well, beloved. We might lose some of our records on earth, but God keeps his own records. We might burn down buildings because we want to hide our iniquity. But God's record cannot be burned. Reminds me of the song we sing in our old primary school. They teach us very useful songs these days. One of them they sang here this morning. Wherever you go, wherever you be, don't say yes when you mean to say no.
They
also taught us in our school in those days. God sees all you do, He hears all you say. My Lord is writing all the time. David killed another man's wife.
David
killed another woman's husband. He thought it was covered. But no. As far as God is concerned, you might have killed a
Goliath.
Your powerful music might have driven out unclean spirits. But you must reap what you sow. And David did. That man you slept with outside marriage, you reap the result. The woman you are sleeping with outside marriage, maybe the result of the low sperm count that is stamping on you now. That pregnancy will terminate to hide shame. Maybe the reason your certificate is getting you no job now, that sex before marriage, maybe the reason why that marriage has not worked. This is a very serious matter. Everything has a day of visitation. The day may come after many years. You may get away from the law because you hired a very good lawyer. But you will still appear at the judgment seat of Christ. Today is the father of tomorrow. Every person is a sower. You will reap the harvest of your planting. Don't be deceived, God is not mocked. Many people are living careless life, indulgent lifestyle.
Say,
when I want to change, I will change. I want to change, I will just change like that. No, you are sowing something. The repercussion will tell. I'm saying all this. So don't just pray empty prayers. I'm saying all this. So you won't be wondering, what did I do wrong? What's happening to me?
There
is only two way out. Two way out. Number one, you need to become a friend of God. Two, you need to connect to what the Bible calls divine mercy. Say, I will have mercy on those of whom I will have mercy. It is to that mercy I want you to connect this day. It's for you to be able to pray that prayer of blind Bartimaeus. From the top of your head to the sole of your feet, that you are praying that prayer. Say, Lord! It's only mercy that can deliver some of us. But the first thing before you even qualify for that mercy, so surrender your life to Jesus. Close your eyes where you are, beloved. If you are here this morning, say, Pastor, I want to surrender my life to Jesus. Wherever you are, while all eyes are closed, please rise your feet. Run quickly to the altar here, or any of the two altars at the back. Don't hesitate. Today is a day of deliverance, a day of power. Say, Pastor, I want to surrender my life to Jesus. Rise up from that feet and run quickly to this altar, or any of the two altars at the back. Any church you are in, go to the altar of that church too. to surrender your life to Jesus. Jesus is waiting for you here. Jesus is waiting for you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Find a way to this altar very quickly. Of you at the altar, I congratulate you. Just bow down your head. Say what I'm going to say after
them.
Say, Father,
Baba,
in the name of Jesus, I come before you now. Lord Jesus, come into my life. Take control of my life. As from today, I say bye bye to the devil. I enter into the kingdom of light. In Jesus' name. Amen. I'm going to pray with you now. Father, I thank you for your children who have surrendered their lives to Jesus today. Father, keep them standing by your power. Lay your hands upon their lives. Anoint them by your power. Today that they have surrendered their lives to Jesus, let their lives no longer remain the same. In Jesus' name we pray. Right there where you are, the counselors will talk with you and teach you the next steps to take. Thank you, Jesus. The rest of us, let's bow down our heads. Thank the Lord to forgive you of any foundational iniquity that is assigned to trouble your destiny. Talk to the Lord now.
Yeah.